Today, 6 must-know tips when using text in Adobe Illustrator, and you're guaranteed to learn at least one thing in today's video. The first must-know tip for using text in Illustrator is utilising the Roman hanging punctuation setting. Now if you have no idea what that is, do not worry because I'm going to demonstrate it right now. When we have text in Illustrator, by default the text would align with the punctuation along whichever side that you align the text to. So for example, you can see here the quotation marks at the top are in line with the lettering. Now this can be annoying or it's simply not ideal for your design. So to change this option, open the paragraph window and activate the Roman hanging punctuation setting. I've made a pink line to demonstrate the changes between having this setting activated or having it turned off. So keep this in mind for your next design when using text in Illustrator. The second must-know tip is another setting that's hidden away for some designers, but this time it's in the Characters window. You can press Command or Control T to open up the Character window. In the fly-down menu in the top right of this window, you will find a setting known as Fractional Widths. Fractional Widths is a more modern and a more advanced method of spacing apart lettering in your text. And to be honest, you probably should always have this setting activated. You can see a slight difference when I turn it off and then turn it back on again, and with certain fonts, the contrast will be more obvious. However, in Photoshop, for some reason, it's even more obvious. So as you can see, the coding between each letter is really, really poor and quite ugly in some areas. So be mindful of this setting and how it can turn your text into an ugly line of typography pretty easily if you leave it turned off. The next pro tip in Illustrator when using text is to use text boxes. Often we just grab the type tool and then start typing, or maybe just copying some text in like so. This often leaves a long stream of text that is annoying to edit and pretty difficult to work with. The more professional and easier way to work is to take the type tool, but to draw out a type box. This will allow you to set up the limits of your text area on your design before you type a single thing. And of course, from here you can go in and make style and layout changes in the character and the paragraph windows. The fourth pro tip is something I was getting wrong for the longest time in my design workflow, and that is to avoid outlining text as much as possible when working in Illustrator. We want to be able to edit our lettering later in a project, and if we outline the text to a vector shape, that will prevent us from doing this. So the first instance where we can actually avoid outlining text is by making a clipping mask. Bring the text layer to the front, select everything, and then right or control click. The clipping mask allows us to still edit the text like so. Changing the text to a compound shape would allow us to add many different effects to our text, such as gradients and other techniques, but we will still be able to change the lettering and the spelling of our typography. This can be activated in the Pathfinder window right here. And lastly, we can use any of the top row functions in the Pathfinder window without aligning the text. All we need to do is hold down the Alt Option key and then use the function in the Pathfinder window. The thing to take away from this tip is to try and avoid outlining your text whenever possible. The fifth tip in today's tutorial is to create a favorites list of your fonts in the character window. all you need to do is to click the star icon next to your most used fonts, and it will be added into the favorites list. This will help you save time in your workflow, as your most used fonts will be right there waiting for you, without you having to scroll through the entire library. And finally, the sixth tip today, when using text in Illustrator, is to utilize the Glyphs panel. You can open up the Glyphs window right here, and in this window, you can see and use every single glyph symbol of a specific font. So right now I've got Helvetica selected, and you can see all of the available glyphs that I have access to. Let's change things up to the amazing and the awesome font that everybody loves, Comic Sans. You will notice a different range of glyphs, and that's because every font family has different choices for you to use. To use a glyph, all you need to do is double click it, and it will be added into your text. So remember everyone, if you want to keep expanding your skills and your awareness as a graphic designer, subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. I make 3 or 4 videos per week on this channel, and I'm always coming up with fresh and new content for you. If you do find my content useful, share it on social media so other people can see it too. Make sure to have a great day everybody, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.